Okay, fine. So,
Good morning.
so we are going to start with the next subtopic in this unit three. So what will happen if there is a friction in a particular when the steam is expanding in the subsequent stages? That is, we call it the preceding stages. So, what is going to happen? That's what we are going to look at. That is, increase in heat drop or isentropic heat drop. Okay, increase in isentropic. Increase in isentropic heat drop, okay, in a stage, okay, in a stage due to friction, due to friction. This is what we are trying to look at now. When I try to draw a corresponding SS diagram or TS diagram, it looks something like this. So if I draw the TS diagram, okay, let me draw both and try to explain. So this is my TS diagram, and I have a corresponding HS diagram also I can draw. So this is my HS diagram, enthalpy, entropy diagram, and this is the dome for my TS diagram. And I can have a similar dome which is little flatter for a HS diagram. Now let's try to TS diagram is actually I can have different temperatures for each stages. That means if I try to look at it, the temperature lines will be going something like this. This is for my the first stage. So this is for my the second stage. So I can have something like this. So for my third, and I can have like this. I can have for n number of things. Let me go for three stages. That's fine. So the corresponding temperature at any given point. So if I try to look at it, this may be if I go for P naught and P naught. Okay. So P1, T1, or you can start with 1, 2, 3, also doesn't matter. Okay. Then P2, P2. Then P3, T3. This is 0, 1, 2, 3. That's all I'm considering. It's not like P naught means it's a stagnation pressure, nothing like that. I can go with either P1, P1, T1 also, it doesn't matter. I can go with that particular thing. Now, if you closely observe, if I go for an isentropic, see, if there is a frictional, see, if you try to calculate the isentropic enthalpy drop in a stage only because of the frictional losses from the preceding stage or from the earlier stage. Okay, now what is the most important thing here is actually we have to look at the equilibrium. See, maybe thermal equilibrium. That means I should not lose any kind of a heat. Okay, I should not lose any kind of a heat. So if you go back and look into what you have studied in your thermodynamics course, thermodynamic equilibrium, what we do, but we are giving more importance to the thermal this thing. So that's why thermal equilibrium becomes most important for us. Now, when we try to look into this particular aspects, I will look into what is the heat loss in each stage. So I have taken some three stages here. So this may be a first stage, a second stage, and third stage. If I have more number of stages, I can go with a fourth stage or fifth stage, doesn't matter. Now, at any given point, if I want to find out what is my heat, what I'm going to save, so if I try to draw a vertical line from here, so say for example, this is the thing what I'm going to do. Okay. Then, so now depending upon my friction, okay, depending upon my friction, so this may be something what I'm changing. So this may be the losses. This are something like what I'm trying to do it actually. Okay. So I'm going to look at each and every stage. What is the, see, what's happening? There is a gain in the entropy. See, there is a, see, as I told that all the processes are irreversible in nature. I can't go towards left-hand side. I can go only towards right-hand side. This is what we have studied in the your second law of thermodynamics. So at any given process, that means why I'm writing it actually. So any expansion you take actually, I'll be moving in this direction. Look at this. I'll be moving in this direction. Okay, that's how I'm going to do. I'm not going to draw that actually. That means if you look at it actually, each and every stage, if I try to color it, if I try to color it, maybe the first one. So if I try to go like this actually, this is what I'm going to see. So if I want, I can go with a different color for the second one. This is what I'm going to see. And for the third one, so this is what I'm going to see. What exactly, what are these actually? So these are nothing much. If at any given point, if I try to measure it, I can call simply, this is your delta S1. Okay, that's for the delta S1. If I go and look into this particular thing, this may be your delta S2. Okay, then if I try to look at it actually, this may be your delta S3. Delta S1, delta S2, delta S3, like that I can go. Now, what will happen if I go in this your vertical direction? It will be corresponding delta T's. So now if I try to look at it, this will be your simple delta T1, delta T2, and delta T3. So now on your TS diagrams, I'll be able to calculate the what will happen to your temperatures, what will be corresponding. This is the, see, this is, this, see, all these things, what are shaded, no? This thing, this one, and this one, these are all because of the friction. This is mainly because of the friction. So when there's a friction, so this is the, this particular thing happens because of the friction, and I could see a corresponding increase in my entropy. So now the same thing I will transfer to my HS diagram. What will happen? So on an HS diagram, if I try to draw the, this are my pressure curves. They are diverging in nature. So this pressure curves here, there. And if I do an isentropic expansion starting from the top, so what will happen? So I may start from this particular point and I may come to, so they have three stages. So this will be my, if I call this as some A, B, C, D, R, 1, 2, 3, 4, doesn't matter. Okay. Now, if I try to look at what will happen at any given point, what is the corresponding enthalpy? See, in the similar fashion, see, I can go and look into, so whatever I've drawn for the this diagram, I can do the same thing. That means, see, this friction, this may be the friction kind of thing. So now, if you look at it actually, there is a corresponding change in my deltas. Okay, there is a corresponding change in my delta C. See, this is mainly because of C. I can call this as delta S1, delta S2, and if I maybe delta S3, whatever you want, that is maybe a change in the corresponding enthalpies actually. Now, if I try to do the same thing, see, this may be, see, this I'm looking at small incremental temperature changes. So here, in a similar fashion, I can look at the small incremental enthalpy changes. That may be your, see, HA minus HB. And here I can call this as delta H1, because this pressure curves are, which are going in the, maybe diverging in nature. So small changes will be this one. So this will be your delta H2. This will be your delta H3. I'm looking at the enthalpies. Now this here, the temperatures are same. See, now this temperatures, what I'm trying to do, this particular thing, delta T's, they're all same. Delta T1 is equal to delta T2, delta 3, just because whatever the lines I'm going to get, that delta T is almost, they are similar. But here, incremental enthalpy changes are different. Because this is mainly because of the saturation temperatures. So it is better to look at the enthalpy change, sorry, enthalpy changes and entropy changes rather than the your temperature changes. So that's the reason why if you go and write the, what is the frictional heat or the frictional reheat, if I go and write the frictional reheat, I can simply call, say for example, this will be, say, if I move on this particular point, A, B, C, D, E. So this will be E, if I point this as E. If I call this as some f, if I call this as some g like that, so each and every point I'm going to get as e. So this particular point, this particular point, and that particular point, e, f, g on the pressure curves, maybe P1, P2, P3, P4. So now there is something called as we have some kind of a stage efficiency associated with that. Okay. Now, if I try to write that, what is the frictional reheat? I can simply write HEC, HA minus HE. Okay. That is, this delta H1 is what actually E minus D. Okay. HE minus, that is your frictional heat loss or frictional reheat. Simply, if you call it as frictional reheat, that is your delta H1, that is HE minus HB, which is your delta H1. Okay, which is depends on, okay, which is actually, see, if you look at it, this is your delta C. Your stage efficiency is actually, if I write it, a stage efficiency will be HA minus HE divided by HA minus HP. This will be a stage efficiency. Then what will be a delta H1? Okay, that is delta H1 will be whatever is left out, that is 1 minus stage efficiency. Okay, I can write 1 minus stage efficiency into HA minus HP. Look at this. This is just a fraction of it. Why I'm calling it as, this is a fraction of this particular thing. Your stage efficiency is HA minus HE divided by HA minus HB. Or your delta H1 actually is your HE minus HB, which is equal to, okay, which is equal to your 1 minus stage efficiency. Maybe stage efficiency is same. So whether I go it for a first stage, whether I go for second stage or third stage, this number will remain the same. Okay. So similarly, okay. Similarly, I can write for the delta S1. Okay. Delta S1, what is actually, we know the TDS equation. What is the TDS equation? So we know TDS equation. So what is my TDS equation? Can anyone tell me what is my TDS equation? BH minus? BH minus?
VDP. VDP, sir.
Okay. Now, these pressures are not changing. So, DH is equal to TDS. Or, I can write at any given point, your same frictional reheat, I can write in terms of delta S1 is equal to this once again. DH, that is delta H1 by corresponding temperature, which may be T1 or T2, whatever. So if I go call this as T1, I can write this will be T1. Or I can write this is equal to 1 minus stage efficiency into HA minus HB, that is enthalpy change, divided by your temperature. Or if I call this as equation number 1, this as equation number 2. Okay, and see your HC, whatever that particular HA minus HB is called as, okay, the fraction frictional reheat because of, see, that particular thing, that is HE minus HB. HE minus HB is called as the frictional reheat mainly because of the energy dissipated only due to friction. So if you call friction, if you go back and look into your gas dynamics and all, maybe compressible flows, you may have shocks. Need not be maybe a normal shock or oblique shock, but there may be whenever a fluid, compressible fluid reaches the Mach number of 1, there can be a little bit of shock. At the same time, not only friction, there may be a little bit of leakage also. So frictional reheat means the losses. What are the losses which are included here? Okay, I can have friction, okay, and I can have, it includes shock and it includes leakage. And see, when these things are happening, actually, what is happening? All these things happening with respect to your steam. We all know that you have your superheated steam, which almost behaves like your ideal gas, superheated steam. We all know that. Now, when we speak of steam, all these frictional things, whether it's a friction or with respect to shock, it can be leakage. So that means we are slowly moving towards a compressible kind of effect. Now, this is about the first stage. What I told is for the first stage. Now, what happened to the second stage? Now, when the second stage, if you look at it, from E to F, okay? And second thing is from B to C. When I move from first stage to second stage, so there is an isentropic enthalpy drop or isentropic heat drop along the line BC. Okay. Now you have to be very careful here. Whether this line EF and BC, they are parallel, need not be. Okay, they are not parallel. There may be a slight change, even though I have written looks parallel, but actually they won't be parallel. There will be a slight deviation because the pressure curves are diverging in nature. If they are not diverging, then those curves would have been not parallel. So if this or maybe this, if those would have been parallel, then your BC and EF would have been parallel to each other. So because of the pressure curves being diverging in nature, BC and EF, they are not parallel. So your EF, what we call EF nightly, because of the diverging in nature, EF is slightly greater than your BC. Okay. Because of, and I'm just trying to recall from your, so this is from the edges diagram. From the edges diagram as the pressure curves are diverging, okay, EF is not parallel, is not parallel to BC, okay, EF is not parallel to BC. That is the first point. The second point is EF is greater than BC. Okay. See, if there is no, see, this is mainly because of friction. If I try to tell that if BC is isentropic, heat drop in the second stage, but actually EF is also isentropic heat drop. See, BC is the isentropic heat drop, EF is also isentropic heat drop in the second stage, but BC is isentropic without friction, EF is isentropic heat drop with friction. Are you getting? Because what I'm trying to do here, actually, I'm trying to consider the EF, which is with the friction, and BC without friction. So if I go with that, actually, there is a slight, see, if I try to go with that, actually, there is a slight, very similar to that. I can have whatever I have, no, this particular curve. So F to C, I will get what is called as your delta H2. That is your second stage. Okay. That is the increase in maybe isentropic heat drop due to friction in the second stage, delta H2. So delta H1 is what I'm trying to look at this particular point. So whatever has happened in the first stage, same thing can happen in second stage also. That is your delta H2. So the frictional heat drop, frictional heat delta H1, there can be a similar thing happen in second stage also, or a similar thing can happen in the third stage also. What I can tell, there is an increase in, I can tell that, increase in, therefore, there is an increase in stage isentropic heat drop. I'm generalizing it. Isentropic heat drop due to friction in each stage. Okay, due to maybe friction means frictional losses. Frictional, let me write it. Frictional losses in each stage. If I go and look into for the second stage, I have to look at the losses from the preceding stage, that is first stage. Then if I go to the third stage, I'll be looking at the frictional losses in the second stage. Each and every stage, I'll be looking at and I'll be moving forward actually. So that's why this is called as, this is mainly because of the friction. So at any given point, what are the thing I'm going to consider? See, if you try to look at it, dh or ds is equal to dh by t. So simply, I can tell that at any given point, dh by t or ds is equal to dh by t at any given point. Okay. If I put it for ds1, if I put it for the first stage, this will be ds1 is equal to dh1 by t1. If I go for a second stage, it will be ds2 is equal to dh2 by t2. If I go for a third stage, this will be ds3 is equal to dh3 by t3. For each stage, I'll be looking at this particular. So there is an increase in isentropic heat drop second stage due to friction. There is an increase in heat drop due to maybe a friction in the third stage. So similar reheating will take place in the succeeding stages. So what we can do is actually a similar kind of heating. Okay. Similar kind of, we call it as reheating, takes place, okay, in the succeeding stage. Okay, in the succeeding stages. Preceding stage. So each and every stage I'm going to take it. So this we have to look at it. ds is equal to dh. So there is an enthalpy change at the corresponding temperature. Entropy change for a enthalpy change for a corresponding temperature. For each and everything, so these all thermodynamics is involved. Because there is an entropy involved here. So I'm going to take first. So if there's a multiple stages, I have to just calculate that and what is the corresponding change in my entropy, ds3 or dh3. So ds3 will be equal to its summation of all. I will be able to get it. Is that clear? For each and every stage. So frictional reheat, what is more important? Okay. Now, see, this is one particular thing which is with respect to your friction actually. In most of the steam, see, whenever we come across this steam, no? So,
sir, we lost your connection, sir.
Yeah, I lost my connection and back. Okay, fine. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I lost my connection. I got back. Okay, fine. That's about your the frictional thing. Frictional loss with respect to this thing. Okay, that's one particular thing. Now, going forward, we all know that the steam will be coming out of, see, if I try to take any HS diagram, 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 this is my HS diagram, okay? This is my HS diagram, and I have the pressure curves which are going like this. Okay, I have two pressure curves. This is one Let me show for one particular stage, so you will be able to understand better. I have for two stages. So this is my P1 and P2. So if an isentropic expansion, okay, I'll be going from, say, call this as from A to B or 1 to 2, doesn't matter. So we call it as some A to B. Okay. Now, actual expansion will be going in this direction. So actual expansion is, there's an increase in my entropy. I'll be going in this direction. So I can call that as C. Okay. Now, when I try to look into the axial velocity, that is exit velocity. Absolutely, if for us to consider the some kind of losses, see, it was supposed to go to a point. See, it was supposed to follow this particular curve, but there is an increase in the exit velocity or terminal velocity as the nozzle accelerates. So, because of that, what will happen? There is a slight increase in my velocity. That means, instead of following the path A to C, it will follow a path like this. It may follow a path like this. See, instead of, see, this should have been your delta S, but this is something which is extra, which is mainly because of your, if you call this as V square by 2, that is mainly kinetic energy. And this is called as terminal velocity. The loss due to, that means, it was supposed to expand to this. This was supposed to be your expansion, delta H. But, so this is my delta H actual. It was supposed, even though, due to terminal velocity, that's we call it the terminal exit velocity of the stream, there is drop in my enthalpy, which is sensible. See, for this, in we are, we try to, okay, correction factor, so we call that as factor for the correction factor for terminal velocity. Terminal velocity. Correction factor for terminal velocity. See, some of the books have seen that it is something like the losses due to residual effects from the last stage. This is more empathy. We can call it as maybe I can emphatically tell that to the last stages of this particular any steam turbine and all, we will see more effect on this particular. This is mainly the law. Maybe if it is a four-stage turbine, the fourth stage we can see this kind of an effect. So there is an enthalpy drop, correction factor, but intermediate stages, the effects are a bit little less actually, comparatively. I'm telling it, but there will be a loss will be there, but comparatively there, it is much less. But in the last stages, this terminal velocity is more because I'm trying to, the steam is trying to exit to maybe your, the pressure to the delta P is, or it may be seeing a downstream pressure which is suitable for it to see an increase in my velocities. Okay, that maybe the kinetic energy loss, maybe we can call this as, if there are, say, for example, if there are n number of stages, okay. So maybe enthalpy at, if I try to put an enthalpy balance between A and B, so HA, what is the enthalpy at A will be equal to, so your, I'm looking at only the actual enthalpy. This will be, we call it as HA minus HC is equal to, okay, your delta H1, or delta HA, that is actual, plus your V square by 2. Okay, or simply, if I take a given point, HA is equal to HC plus delta HA plus V square by 2. Okay, there V is called the terminal velocity. V is called the terminal velocity. So one more big thing what we have to look at is here actually, a good amount of terminal velocity will reduce your work done, internal work done especially. See, if this number, if V tends to increase, then the work done reduces. Because what's happening? See, your HA plus HCA, so this particular quantity, this will decrease your work done factors. Our work done will, our internal work done will slowly will get reduced because of the increase in my exit velocity or terminal velocities. This is one factor. One is mainly because of the friction, another one is mainly because of the terminal. So both will, see, one will try to drop in your engine. See, if you look at it, both actually, is there friction, maybe a shock or leakage, another one is the terminal velocity. All these things will lead to drop in your enthalpies. Okay, drop in your enthalpies. So there is a drop. So this is mainly, see, if you look at it, this is actually, this is your kinetic energy. That means I'm going to, so there's a loss due to, that's a change due to kinetic energy. Now, with this kinetic energy considering, with this kinetic energy considered, so is it possible for us to come up with an expression? Okay, come up with an expression. See, correction factor, that means reheat factor, then its corresponding correction factor. So what is the reheat factor? So reheat factor for any expansion. See, if I consider any kind of an adiabatic process, maybe for a steam and all, and with a, we all know that the stage efficiency is constant or remains same, or a design stage efficiency we call. So for a given design stage efficiency, so we can obtain the expression for reheat factor in terms of maybe the pressure ratio and index of coefficient. So let's try to obtain the expression for that. So what is the expression? The reheat factor for an expansion. Okay. The reheat factor expression for reheat factor. Okay, reheat factor for an expansion from the turbine, that is the expansion to the turbine with some kind of an uniform, with a uniform or a constant adiabatic index, with a uniform adiabatic index, and maybe it's a designed stage efficiency, which is also constant. So for that, we need to come up with an expression for this particular reheat factor. Okay. Here, when you try to look into this particular thing, let's try to look at it actually. That is, what are the things they are telling? Your stage efficiency is constant. This is one thing. Then the index of expansion, that is, n dash or gamma, okay? So you can have either gamma or n dash, which is your adiabatic index or expansion index. Expansion index, okay. Then if I go with CM, which is your polytropic index. So I'm trying to consider these three quantities. Stage efficiency. So stage efficiency means, because I'm going with multiple stages, one stage, sorry, more than one stage, two stages or three stages, doesn't matter. Okay. At the same time, n dash, see, what is this n dash? N dash is the mainly because of the, your, what we call it as maybe the expansion index. Okay. Now, When I try to look at this expansion index, actually, if you go back and see your nozzles and diffuser, go back, maybe let me call that as a little bit of a note. Okay. You might have studied maybe gamma or something for a nozzle. Okay. The nozzle and a diffuser. Just to go back and nozzles and diffuser, you might have studied this. The gamma is equal to n by n minus eta into n minus 1. Okay, I'm going to use, instead of gamma, I'm going to call it as n dash. That's it. So n dash divided, n divided by n minus gamma into n minus 1. This I'm taking from your nozzles and diffusers equation. Okay. So we see, this is the modified, this is the modified P V taper of gamma. It's called as P V taper of gamma. I can call it as P V taper of n dash. Both I can use either gamma or n dash, doesn't matter. Both are same. And where, from where it has come? It has come from here, nozzles and diffuser equation. So which you see, if you look at it closely, this is, eta is the element stage efficiency. So there I'm not calling it a stage efficiency. So here, the eta is your stage efficiency, because there it was with respect to nozzles. I was applying with respect to nozzles. So here, instead of simply eta, I'm going to use stage efficiency, that is eta s. An isentropic index, that is your n is your maybe polytropic index. Okay, n is your polytropic index. So I can call, so I can write the modified form of, is actually a modified form, I can write either n dash or eta, whatever I want, I can new or whatever about both I can write it. So this will be for turbine. For turbine, I can write either n dash is equal to n divided by n minus stage efficiency into n minus 1. So let me call this as equation number 1. Okay. Now, what is the reheat factor? See, reheat factor means actually, this is what you have for the, maybe if I go for multiple stages, work done in n number of stages divided by work done in a single stage. Okay. That is, reheat factor is equal to simple delta H divided by delta dash isentropic in a single stage. Or you can call C means it is cumulative or something like that. Okay. Now, what is this delta H cumulative and all, if I try to write in terms of maybe your gamma or N dash? Okay. Gamma or N dash or isentropic, if I try to write it, if you go back a little bit on your thermodynamics. Hope you remember delta H is equal to n by n minus 1 into P1 V1. Okay. In P1 V1, 1 minus 1 by pressure ratio whole to the power of n minus 1 by n. Hope you remember this particular formula. This you might have studied in your thermodynamics course. Just a recalling. Okay. This recall, that is delta H. Let me write in different color, so it will be easy for you. This you might have studied. Delta H is equal to n by n minus 1, okay, into P1 V1, 1 minus 1 by pressure ratio, that is, okay, 1 by 1 minus the pressure ratio whole to the power of n minus 1, that is our gamma minus 1. Okay, this gamma minus 1. If I take gamma here, it will be n. If I take n here, it will be n. So n minus 1 by n. Okay, this is the expression. So I can replace n by gamma. So whatever the way I want, this you might have studied in your thermodynamics course. So for a polytropic, this should have been derived in your basic thermodynamics course. I don't want to derive the same thing. I will use it the same thing for your, maybe for your cumulative as well as for isentropic. So for an isentropic, it will be polytropic index. And for a cumulative, it is your n dash or gamma I'm going to use it. So therefore, I can write delta H cumulative, I can write it as either n dash or gamma, whatever you want, I can write. this will be n dash by n dash minus 1 into p1 v1 into 1 minus, what is pressure ratio? It is p2 by p1. That is 1 by pressure ratio is p2 by p1, okay, whole to the power of n dash minus 1 by n dash. Okay, so this is for your delta H cumulative or whatever it may be, axial or whatever. So if I go for a single stage, delta K isentropic. Okay, see, either you can go with the n dash or if you can go with the expansion index, you can go with it, or you can go with n. See, here, some of the books, they n itself, they call it as expansion index. So both are interchangeable. Either you can, n itself, you can call it as polytropic index, or n itself, you can call it as adiabatic index, or n, you can call it as expansion index, doesn't matter. So only the notations are changing, that's it. Either go with n or either go with n dash, it's left to you people. And pressure ratio, see, some books they call it as P1 by P2 and 1 upon C. This is 1 upon PR, oh, sorry. This is actually 1 upon PR. This is 1 upon PR. So pressure ratio, that's why it is P2 by P1. So few books they call simply pressure ratio as P2 by P1, or if you take 1 upon PA, 1 upon R, it will be P1 by P2. So both the way, it's correct. The only thing is how you are applying in your equation is what it matters. Okay. How you are applying in your this thing is what it matters. Okay. Now, delta H isentropic, it will be N by N minus 1 into P1 V1 into 1 minus 1 by P2 by P1 whole to the power of n minus 1 by n. So n, you can take it as adiabatic or expansion index, doesn't matter. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to call R is equal to pressure ratio P2 by P1. So therefore, I can write this expression RF. RF is equal to n dash by n dash minus 1 into P1 V1 into 1 minus 1 by R to the power of n dash minus 1 by n dash whole thing divided by, okay, whole thing divided by n by n minus 1 into p1 v1 1 minus 1 by r to the power of n minus 1 by n minus 1 by n. This is the expression what I'm going to get. Okay, now further simplification, I can write the reheat factor RS is equal to n dash into n minus 1, okay, into 1 minus P1 V1, just simply cancel out, 1 minus 1 by R to the power of n dash minus 1 by n dash whole thing divided by n into n dash minus 1 into 1 minus 1 by R to the power of n minus 1 by n. Okay, this expression what I'm going to get it in terms of n, n and n dash. Okay, now what I did actually, just I went and I replaced the your what we call it as your delta HC and delta isentropic, I just substituted. Now what is your n dash? So go back and see here. This n dash is equal to n divided by n into stage efficiency into n minus 1. Okay. Substituting for, so if I call this as equation number 2, this is almost like 80% done. Now to refine that expression, so substituting for n dash in equation 2. Okay, so what it is actually, your RF is equal to, wherever your n dash, I'm going to substitute it. What is your n dash? N dash is equal to your n by, see, it is n by n minus your stage efficiency into n minus 1 into n minus 1 into 1 minus 1 by r to the power of n dash minus 1 by n whole thing divided by, okay, n into, so wherever your n dash I'm going to put it, that is n divided by n minus stage efficiency into n minus 1 minus of 1 into 1 minus 1 by r to the power of n minus 1 by n. This is the expression. Okay. Now I have to simplify this further. So what simplification? What simplification I can do? So if you look at the numerator, you have this particular thing, n into n minus 1 divided by n into n minus 1 into eta s into n minus 1. The numerator, I'm going to get only n into n minus 1. Okay, so I can replace. So this will be simply n into n minus 1 into 1 minus 1 by r to the power of n dash minus 1 by n whole thing divided by simply this will be n into, so that is n minus stage efficiency into n minus 1. Okay, others on one side. And if I do this particular thing, simplify n, if I take it outside, okay, this will be n into n minus 1. I can write n minus eta efficiency into n minus 1. Okay. Yeah, that's one thing. So minus n and n outside. Okay. Whole thing. Just taking simplifying it. Whole thing I can replace by n minus eta s into, n minus eta s into n minus 1. Okay, that's fine. Into, I'm just jumping few steps actually so that directly I can write it. That is n minus 1 by n. So that these two things just they cancel out. This thing just they cancel out. So that it becomes simplifying factor. That is, so I'm left with your eta s, this n and this n also will just simply cancel out. So minus into this particular thing. So I'm left with minus into minus, this will be plus. Okay. So minus into minus, this will be plus actually. This will be plus. So I'm left with the reheat factor is equal to 1 by stage efficiency into, okay, into n into n minus 1, that also will just cancel out. This n into n minus 1, this also will just simply cancel out. N into n minus 1 and all, just simply cancel out. I'm going to be left with only 1 minus 1 by r to the power of n dash minus 1 by n, okay, divided by 1 minus 1 by r to the power of n minus 1 by. Yeah, I think you will get it. Maybe a couple of steps if you do that, you'll be getting this. Okay. Now, even in the numerator also, wherever you have n dash, there also you can substitute in terms of eta s into that also you can do that. It's not an issue. Okay, so wherever you have this particular thing, this particular eta dash n dash is there, no? Here also you can don't do it one particular step actually to the, that is to the power of. So once you get this expression, substitute for n dash here also. Substitute for n dash here so that you will get in terms of stage efficiency. So this will be the final expression. That is the final expression for the reheat factor. This is the expression for the reheat factor considering the stage effects or stage efficiency for any given turbine or for any multiple, we call it as maybe multi-stage, that is two stage or three stage. This is what is going to